Hello and welcome to ThriveTracker. During the course of this video, we'd like to introduce you to our new platform dashboard, as well as some of the different navigational features, tips, and tricks that will help you get the most out of your ThriveTracker account. At the very top of the screen, you'll see that there's a green bar stating profit is higher than yesterday. One of the best things that we did in updating our dashboard was ensuring that you were being provided as a client with money-making information right away. To go along with this, we also wanted to make sure that the ThriveTracker platform dashboard was also mobile-friendly. If, for instance, I was accessing my platform dashboard on an iPhone X, it would look like you see on the screen. You'll notice all the same information is being displayed, from the green bar as well all the way to the 8 tiles that are beneath it. Not only that, but we're also showcasing the same information within those tiles that you would see on the desktop version. Now, these 7 bars in each one of these tiles are showcasing data from the last 7 days. As you'll see here, it is the same information that you'd see otherwise. Now, further within those 8 tiles, you'll see that there are 2 with green arrows in them, both on the profit side and on the ROI side. Those green arrows represent increases over the previous day. Going further down the page, you'll notice there's a graph with 2 different data points being displayed: profit in the dark blue and ROI in the light blue. What's important to note about this graph is that you have to measure these according to the side that has the correct scale. So, for instance, profit is measured against the left side, while ROI is being measured against the right. Additionally, this graph can showcase multiple items. You'll see there are 5 in total. The other options are cost and cost per click, clicks and click-through rate, conversion and conversion rate, or revenue and profit. Going further down the page, you'll notice that there's a huge difference between the old dashboard and the new one, and it's our inclusion of both positive and negative statistics in these 4 categories. The negative statistics are shown in red, while the positives are shown in green, and they are the top 5 best and worst performing campaigns, offers, landing pages, or traffic sources for the date range being provided. What's important about this is that when you're on the go, logging in on a mobile device, or just looking for a quick snapshot of the best and worst things happening in your account right now, this is where you can find it. Additionally, if, for instance, you wanted to check out the campaign that is performing worst, as you see here, it's Test 12, I could actually click directly on Test 12 and go directly to that campaign to start analyzing how it could potentially improve the results. Further down the screen, you'll notice our portfolio performance portion. This breaks down your last 7 days individually, as well as the last 7 days together, the last 15 days, 30 days, or this month, last month, month before last, or all-time statistics. I mentioned earlier that a large portion of our focus was in making sure that the mobile display was just as comprehensive as the desktop display. And as you'll see here, while you do have to toggle between top performers and loss leaders, you are getting the same great information that you would see on the desktop portion in a mobile optimized view. Just the same, the portfolio performance tab, if you click show all, it will still show all of the same great information you saw on the desktop. You'll just have to open up the dropdowns to see all of the different data points being displayed. Here on the left side menu, you'll find each of the various useful features that ThriveTracker offers. They are compressed to start out, but if you go to the top portion, you can open up that menu and see all of the various icons and what they pertain to. This will help you learn those icons a little bit faster. When you're done, simply select the arrow again, they'll collapse back in. At the very top of the screen, you'll notice there's a portion for current date and time. It's important to take note of this because when you set up your account, you selected a time zone. However, you don't always have to set your time zone to where you live. Some folks see it as a great option to set your time zone to either where they prefer to buy their traffic or where they prefer to sell their traffic. It can be easier to compare performance in platforms when the time zones line up. This is the default, and we can set up your ThriveTracker time zone for any time zone on the planet. But it's important to note as well that you can view campaign statistics in individual time zones also. Moving further over, you'll notice that there is a notifications tab. This is specifically for if our staff need to send you, the user, any specific notifications, you'd find them here. Moving further over, under the settings menu, you'll find the option to check out multi-user access. That's under the manage subusers portion. You'll find our settings menu where you can select some of the different ways to customize your account. For instance, changing the default redirect method to your offer pages or setting up rev share rules. Additionally, you'll find the different information for our API and getting that set up. If you'd like to go ahead and build on top of our API, you'd need to set up using the authentication tab. And then it would allow you to view all of the various methods that you can make calls with. You can also change which information and data points are being shown within the various tables and graphs in Thrive. Or you can go directly to our migration center where we can break down the various ways that ThriveTracker can help you make the switch to Thrive easier and more efficient. Some methods are easier than others, so it might be helpful to talk with our staff about some of the different ways we can do so and what's going to be the best option for you. Last on the right are some of the different account pieces regarding managing your setup. Under the billing portion, it would take you to our accounts.thrivetracker.com interface where you can change your credit card information, collect your account invoices and other such things. Or you can go directly to our support desk where you'll be able to go ahead and get any help or tutoring that our support staff can provide you. Additionally, on the dashboard, there is a button again to reach the support center. You can also create a campaign directly from the dashboard. It would go ahead and take you to that interface without having to go through the campaigns menu first. And last but not least, our video tutorial section. Here, just like the video that you're watching right now, you'll find a number of great videos offering you more help in getting better acquainted with your account, learning the new features that are available to you, and getting the most out of ThriveTracker. In addition to these videos, our support center includes dozens of great support docs built, written, and approved by our staff to provide incredible information. Or if there are still questions that you need answers to, I encourage you to reach out to our support team directly. Those folks will be ready with answers to help you get the most out of ThriveTracker.